Have you spent the last couple months or even the last year researching how to buy a home here in San Diego only to feel like you got your rug swept right up from underneath your feet with this pandemic and everything that's going on? It's okay. There are three questions that you need to ask yourself before considering buying a house. Hi, my name is Dan Parker and I buy and sell real estate right here in San Diego. And I'm here to tell you that not all hope is lost. In fact, there actually might be some benefits increasing for buyers that want to buy a home in the next couple of months. So the first question that you need to ask is the housing market on the brink of collapse? That's what I hear over and over again. And there are some really key data points that we can analyze to help you get a better idea of what we can expect in the upcoming months, upcoming years. So there's two main points that you need to know here. First, recessions don't always lead to a decline in housing prices. In fact, out of the last five recessions in the US since 1980, twice have housing prices gone down. One of which was in 1990 when housing prices only came down by 1%. In all of the other recessions, housing prices actually went up. The second part to know here is when housing prices did come down in 2008, it was actually largely the housing crisis that led to the recession, not the other way around. And this was caused in a large part because of shady lending practices, essentially allowing just about anyone with a pulse to be able to take a loan out for a house, even if they couldn't afford it. And the second question that you need to be asking is, what is the current data showing? It's really, really important that you stick with local data over nationwide because every single market can be different. Here in San Diego, for example, we've had a massive housing inventory shortage over the last couple of years. So let's talk inventory. It's generally accepted that around 6 months of inventory is the most neutral, balanced market between buyers and sellers. It's not a buyer's market, it's not a seller's market. It's talking about how many homes are available compared to how many people are buying homes on a daily basis. So if 6 months is neutral, San Diego has been a strong seller's market for the last couple of years, hovering at around 2 months of inventory. Now, the lower that inventory goes, the stronger the seller's market is. Up to the beginning of 2020, January, February, even going into March, there were certain areas that were so low on inventory, they were down to a week or less of inventory. That's right. A neutral market is around 6 months. We got down to a week or less in San Diego. So inventory was so incredibly short that pretty much the day a home hit the market, it was getting dozens of offers. You had all these people to fight for that property. So that is how strong our inventory or how low our inventory is in San Diego. So with that bit of insight on inventory in San Diego, it's good to note that we actually have a long way to go just to become a neutral market. It has to go through being a neutral market to being a buyer's market for home prices to collapse, to fall down on a significant level. So are there fewer buyers out there today than there were 2 months ago? Absolutely. There are fewer buyers, but that is a good thing if you want to buy a house because there's less competition for those properties. It is good to note today in San Diego, 152 new properties hit the market in San Diego County, 161 properties were sold. That's right, with quarantine, with everything going on, properties are still being sold, they're still being sold for top dollar, and they are still being sold fast. So the very last and potentially the most important question is, how do you avoid risk in this market? As a buyer, you really want to avoid losing money or defaulting on a mortgage. That is extreme high priority. So the two ways that you can do to minimize that risk is, first, don't consider buying a house right now if you have any risk of losing your job. If you have job security, that's fantastic because not everyone has that right now. And that's gonna make you more competitive, but it's gonna give you more confidence in being able to afford the property that you want to afford. Now, the second part is you want to make sure that you are working with someone who is extremely familiar with the new COVID-19 forms specific for real estate that were released by the California Association of Realtors. These forms can offer you added protection if there are any delays, issues, or cancellations when you're purchasing a property. It gives you extra protection so that you can get your money back in case there are any issues throughout the process. One thing is for certain, we are sure dealing with some unprecedented times. So the best we can do is take some hints from the past along with current market data to make the best decision possible for your future. If you want to stay up to date with the San Diego real estate market, consider subscribing to my channel, maybe even hitting that bell icon down in the corner so you can be notified every time I upload a new video. Now, if you are considering buying or selling a home here in San Diego County in the near future, reach out to me. My contact information is below. Let's start a conversation and see if I can help you out. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you next time.